Good evening everyone, my name is Anita. I am working as an assistant professor in St. Martin's Engineering College. Today I am discussing semiconductor topic. So, semiconductor. Before semiconductor topic, what is the types of materials? So, based on atom structure and based on flow of electricity, materials are three types. Conductor. Based on electric flow of electricity, conductor, semiconductor, insulator. Later, conductor. What is conductor? Conductor is a substance in which electrically charged carriers atoms moves easy to in the substance. Then the flow of electricity is conductor is maximum, means flow of electricity possibility in conductors. What is insulator? Example of conductor is metals. Next, what is insulator? Insulator is a substance do not allow the flow of electricity. Example is wood. So what is semiconductor? Semiconductor is a substance. These properties lies in between conductor and insulator. So the energy bond gap is same as insulator of semiconductor at 0 degrees, absolute 0 degrees temperature it will act as a insulator, and at high temperature it will act as a conductor. Means semiconductor means semi means of. So these properties lies in between conductor and semiconductors at two conditions. One is at 0 degree temperature it will act as a conductor, it will act as a insulator, and at high degree temperature it will act as a conductor in the presence of impurities atoms. Okay, now semiconductors presence of impurities based on impurity atoms classified into two types: extrinsic semiconductor, intrinsic semiconductor. What is intrinsic semiconductor? Intrinsic semiconductor is a few form of semiconductor. Examples are germanium and silicon. Extrinsic semiconductor contains the impurity atoms. In intrinsic semiconductor, why taking the germanium and silicon? So these consist of valency electrons 4. Okay. Now, an extrinsic semiconductor based on what is it? It contains impurity atoms, na? Based on impurity atoms, again classified into two types: p-type and n-type semiconductors. Okay. Now, what is p-type and what is n-type? P-type is a doped with. Before going to learn what is doping. Doping is a process of addition of impurity atoms to intrinsic semiconductors. Okay. Now, that purpose taking the, these are impurity intrinsic semiconductors, germanium and silicon. And what is p-type and n-type? N-type is, these two are related to extrinsic semiconductors. So, what is doping? Doping is a process of addition of impurity atom to the intrinsic semiconductors. So again, what is p-type? P-type semiconductor, a small trivalent impurity to add a intrinsic semiconductor that form the that resultant substance is called p-type material. So trivalent impurities. Trivalent impurities means valency shell is consist of 3 electrons. So 3 plus 3. Valency shell of electrons 3. And what is n-type valency shell of electrons? 5. Pentavalent impurities added to a intrinsic semiconductor then only form the n-type semiconductor. Okay. Now what is 3-type? Trivalent impurities means third group elements. This means fifth group elements. These are fourth group elements. Okay. Now trivalent impurities. Boron, aluminium and pentavalent impurities. Nitrogen, phosphorus, bismuth, stibium, gallium, indium, thallium. These are trivalent, these are pentavalent impurities. Now form the p-type and n-type semiconductors. First, n-type semiconductor. Taking the n-type semiconductor, phosphorus is pentavalent impurities. So it consists of 5 free electrons. And germanium 4. These are germanium 4. These are 5. This way from the p-type semiconductor, one more electron is free. Means this is donor level of electron. This total, this substance p-type and this level is called donor level. Means this is ready to bond another also. Next, what is p-type? So in that same process, trivalent impurity. Trivalent impurity consider as aluminium. Aluminium only 3 electrons, 3 only, 1, 2, 3. And germanium tetravalent impurity, tetravalent, then form the bond of electrons and p-type semiconductors majority charge carriers are holes. This is acceptor level of energy gap. This is the p-type and n-type semiconductors. Next, discussing the energy levels of p-type and n-type with Fermi levels. Energy level, this downside state is valency band, means contains the valency energy, and it contains the conduction band. Conduction band between valency band and conduction band, that is different from n-type and p-type semiconductors. First, before going to energy gap, what is Fermi level of n-type and p-type? In that Fermi level means what? Fermi level and acceptor donor. These two things are plot on the diagram. Okay, first, this is n-type. So in that n-type semiconductor, This is donor level. Donor level means this, what is Fermi level? Fermi level is A. It is a top of the energy level at 0 degree temperature or at absolute temperature that is nearer to the conduction band in n-type semiconductors. EF. And this is donor level na ED. These two are nearer to the conduction band in n-type semiconductors. Same thing happened in p-type semiconductor. This is acceptor level. This is acceptor level only na. That same Fermi level is nearer to the valency band. And acceptor level band also nearer to the valency band. Next, biasing of p-n. Biasing of P and N type semiconductors. So, biasing P type semiconductor consists of majority charge carriers, holes. So when battery is connected to p-type, generally before going to biasing, what is going on p-type semiconductor while battery is connected, then this charge hole is positive charge na, so positive and positive repelled from the junction. And next to same thing happens combination of n-type semiconductor, then connect the n-type. Before connection, what happened? The negative terminal electrons, majority charge carriers, electrons consist of negative electrons having negative charge. Negative charge of the electrons and negative charge of the battery, both are repelled. So, combination of p-type and n-type semiconductor is called diode. Combination of p and n-type semiconductor is called diode. Both in connect the one battery. So, that connection is called biasing. Biasing also forward bias, reverse bias. Two types, forward and reverse bias. So measuring the current in both types. First of all, connect the battery positive to positive, negative to negative. Then what happened? Then repelled from the both terminals, positive to positive, repelled from this one and attract to the electrons, negative charge carriers. P-type. And this same thing happened, negative terminal is repelled and attacked towards the positive terminals. Then form a bond gap that is very less amount. That time to flow the current is maximum. The band gap is EG is minimum. In that disc, biasing is called forward bias. That time energy gap of material is, diode is minimum, current flow is maximum. Due to the majority charge carriers of PN junction, current flow is maximum. And reverse bias condition, reverse bias, same thing, P type and N type semiconductor taking, connect the one battery and one ammeter also, because current flow minimum or maximum showing in the reading. Ammeter, so positive is this time. P-type semiconductor consists of majority charge carriers, holes, and N-type electrons. Charge is negative. Then same thing, negative, this positive. This negative terminal is attracted to the junction. In that junction, holes will attracted to the battery negative, and electrons will attracted to the positive terminal of the battery. Then energy gap is increases. That time less current will flow on the circuit. Less current flow on the circuit. Energy gap is maximum. Current flow is less. So this finding the energy gap, one principle and experiment also given in the class. First of all, what is energy gap? Energy gap between valence band and conduction band.
Thank you.
Thank you.